लास्ट लेक्चर वी सॉ दैट हाउ कैन वी मेक ए शॉर्टकी जंक्शन बिटवीन ए मेटल एंड ए एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी सी द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ ए शॉर्टकी जंक्शन अंडर डिफरेंट एक्सटर्नल बायसिंग कंडीशन. सो वी नो दैट देर कैन बी और देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ बायसिंग. फर्स्ट वन इज फॉरवर्ड बायस इन फॉरवर्ड बायस मेटल इज कनेक्टेड टू द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल एंड एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर. इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. दिस इज फॉर व्हेन वी मेक ए शॉर्टकी जंक्शन बिटवीन ए मेटल एंड ए एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर. बट व्हेन वी मेक ए शॉर्टकी जंक्शन बिटवीन ए मेटल एंड ए पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर देन फॉर फॉरवर्ड बायसिंग कंडीशन वी हैव टू रिवर्स दिस कनेक्शन. दैट इज वी हैव टू अप्लाई ए नेगेटिव पोटेंशियल टू द मेटल एंड ए पॉजिटिव पोटेंशियल टू द पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर. सो फर्स्ट दिस इज अवर फॉरवर्ड बायस कंडीशन एंड वी नो दैट सेकेंड वन इज रिवर्स बायस. सो इन रिवर्स बायस मेटल इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल एंड एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर. To the positive terminal of the battery. This reverse condition is only applicable when we make a Schottky junction between a metal and a n-type semiconductor. But when we want to make a Schottky junction between metal and a p-type semiconductor, then we have to again reverse this condition. That is, we have to connect metal to the positive terminal of the battery and p-type semiconductor to the negative terminal of the battery. So first let me explain this forward bias condition or performance of a Schottky junction under this forward bias condition. So first let me make the energy diagrams for this Schottky junction. We know that all the band bending is in the semiconductor only, and there is no band bending in metal side. So this is energy level for vacuum, that is E vac. This is Fermi level of the metal, and now this is the Fermi level of the system under equilibrium condition. Similarly, this is vacuum condition for this semiconductor, and this is EC and this is EV. So we know that this distance is V naught, that is built-in potential or contact potential, and this height is known as Schottky barrier height. So this is when we are not applying any external bias. So for forward bias condition, we have to apply a positive potential to the metal. This is metal side, and from here to here, this is n-type semiconductor, and we know that this is the depletion width W. So for making a forward bias, we have to apply a positive potential to the metal and a negative potential to the metal. So let me draw again energy band diagram. So this is Schottky junction, and under forward bias condition, that is we are applying a positive potential to the metal side and a negative potential to the n-type semiconductor side. So this is under forward bias condition. This bending and this bending are equal in amount. Let me make it. So this is in forward bias condition. So here we know that when we apply a negative potential, due to this negative potential, the potential energy of the electrons in semiconductor side will go in upward direction, and due to a positive potential, this side will go in downward direction. So ultimately there is a reduction in the contact potential. So here we can see that there is a very small potential or contact potential. So now electrons from this n-type semiconductor can move to the metal side easily, or we can get a sufficient current under this forward bias condition. So this is all about the forward bias condition. Now let me write these points. So we know that in a forward bias condition, or in a forward bias Schottky junction, the external potential is applied in such a way that it opposes the built-in potential. Or contact potential. And the voltage drop is across the depletion region due to its high resistance or resistivity. We know that under external bias, the Fermi levels the Fermi levels no longer line up. So here in above diagram we can see, as I said earlier, that when we apply a negative potential to this side and a positive potential to this side, so the Fermi level of this side will go in the upward direction. Here it's not showing clearly, so let me draw it again. And this upward and downward of the Fermi levels depends upon the external bias. So now it's clear that when we apply a bias, either it's forward or reverse bias, there is no line up between these Fermi levels. So under external bias, the Fermi levels no longer line up. But are shifted to one another, and the magnitude of the shifting depends on the applied voltage. Thus, electrons injected from the external circuit into the N-type semiconductor have a lower barrier to surmount before reaching the metal. This leads to a current in the circuit. Which increases with the external potential. And the current in a Schottky junction under forward bias can be written as J, which is equal to J naught exponential EV by KT minus 1. This is similar to the current that we got in a PN junction under forward bias condition. So this is the current density in a Schottky junction under forward bias condition, where J naught is again as the reverse saturation current. and it is important to know that J naught is a constant. That depends on the Schottky barrier, that is phi b, for the system and the expression can be written as, so J naught can be written as A T square exponential minus phi b by kt. Let me give a number to every equation. So let's, this is the equation number 1. And this is the equation number 2. And in this equation, A is the Richardson constant. Richardson constant for the thermionic emission, or simply this is a Richardson constant and it depends upon the material, that is it's a material property. So this Richardson constant may be different for different material. And here we can see that this reverse saturation current doesn't depend upon the applied voltage. It only depends upon the barrier height and some other properties of the material. But in equation number first, we can see that the current density, or simply current in a Schottky junction under forward bias condition, is directly proportional to the exponential of the applied voltage, or the forward current depends upon the applied voltage and it increases exponentially with the applied voltage. We can write this line, that equation 1 shows that in the forward bias the current increases exponentially with the applied potential. So this is all about the current in a Schottky junction under forward bias condition. So now let me take reverse bias condition. So in the case of a reverse bias, the external potential is applied in the same direction as the contact potential or junction potential or built-in potential. So if you take a energy band diagram after applying a reverse bias condition, so this is the so now we have to apply a negative potential to this metal side and a positive to the n-type semiconductor side. This is the starting of the depletion region. So now there is more bending of energy bands in the semiconductor side. So now this is the bending. This is Fermi level for the metal and this is Fermi level for the n-type semiconductor. This is E vacuum, this is EC, this is EV. We know all these terms. So now we have to apply a negative potential to the metal and a positive potential to the n-type semiconductor. As we know that we are applying a negative potential to this metal side, so Fermi level of the metal will move in the upward direction, and due to this positive potential, the Fermi level of this n-type semiconductor will move in the downward direction. So now this contact potential will increase, which is equal to, let me write it, V total, which is equal to V naught, that is built-in potential, plus applied voltage V. So this is the total potential. So when we apply this reverse bias, once again the Fermi levels no longer line up, but the barrier for electron motion from the n-type semiconductor to metal becomes higher. Now, since the contact potential has been increased, to move electron from this semiconductor side to metal side have to get extra energy, which is equal to E into V total. The electron flow is now from the metal to semiconductor and the barrier for this is given by the Schottky barrier. That is 5B. Here we can see that we applied a negative potential to the metal side. So now electron should move from metal to semiconductor side. And to move from metal to semiconductor side, electrons of the metals would have to an energy which is equal to or greater than this energy, which is equal to 5B. So if an electron has an energy which is equal to or greater than this 5B, then that electron can move from metal to semiconductor side. So in reverse bias condition, if electron want to move from semiconductor to metal, then that electron has to get this amount of energy. And if an electron from metal side to semiconductor side want to go, then that electron must have this amount of energy. So in reverse bias condition, there is a constant current which is equal to J naught. That is, in reverse bias condition, we can only get this reverse saturation current, and this J naught we know that is equal to AT square exponential minus 5B by KT, as we write in this equation number second. So in forward bias condition, we get a current or current density which is equal to J naught, and that current depends exponentially of the applied voltage. But in reverse or in reverse bias condition, the current we get only the current which is equal to the reverse saturation current, and that doesn't depend upon the external potential, and this current only depends upon the barrier height and other constant properties of the material. And it is important to know that the current in the forward bias condition is orders of magnitude higher than the current in the reverse bias. So if you draw IV characteristic for this Schottky junction, it will look like this. On this coordinate, this is V, that is applied potential, and here I am writing I not J. We can write J also in a similar manner. So here the current in milliampere scale, and here the current in microampere scale. So for forward bias condition, we get a current where there is a exponential relation between V and I, but in reverse bias condition we get a constant current that only depends upon the barrier height and other properties of the material. So this current is about 1 microampere, and normally here knee voltage is very low. So this is the IV characteristic of a Schottky junction. From this IV characteristic, we can see that the current in the forward bias is higher than the current in the reverse bias. And there is, if we take example of a Schottky junction, we can take the junction between gold or AU and N-type silicon is always a Schottky junction. So in this lecture we can see the performance of this Schottky junction under forward bias condition and reverse bias condition. In forward bias condition, we can see that the applied voltage is acting in a opposite manner of the contact potential. So we get a sufficient current which is equal to J naught exponential EV KT minus 1. Here we can see that this current or current density depends on the external applied or external voltage. Here J naught is the reverse saturation current, and in the reverse bias condition we only get a reverse saturation current that does not depend upon the external voltage, and it only depends upon the barrier, Schottky barrier of the system. So in next lecture we will see the ohmic junction between a metal and a semiconductor.